It's a document that may not seem like a big deal, but the city's plans will have a profound effect on everybody. Acting as a 20-year blueprint for development, the 100-plus page document sets out targets for new homes, jobs and infrastructure. Work on the key plans began more than 2 years ago. But after the government inspector ruled the council falling far short of its housing quota, city leaders had to go back to the drawing board.
So we developed a plan, a draft, we submitted it, and the first draft was rejected. There was about 95-96% of it was fine, but then the inspector felt we had to do much more to fit in more housing, and we're a very constrained city. We have the downs to the north of us and something wet and cold called the sea to the south of us.
With the city plan going back to the drawing board, it not only means that an agreement on a long-term solution for Brighton and Hove's housing problem is yet to be found, but also that costs of implementing the plan are on the increase.
Well, it is worrying because land use consultants were hired by the council to undertake the survey of the urban fringe, and of course a lot of officer time has been spent on this already, and public consultation is expensive as well.
The inspector obviously has her view of the situation. It's extremely difficult in Brighton and Hove because we have the sea on the one side, we have the downs on the other, we're very built up, and you need infrastructure and such like if you're going to increase your numbers. So it is extremely difficult here, and there's lots of students, they've got to be catered for. It's not an easy issue.
Councillors are set to discuss the plans next month, but whether or not they meet the expectations from Whitehall is yet to be seen. The longer the delay, the less control residents will have on the future of their own city. This is James Dunham for Latest TV News.